Eh, look, you know, karakter kita tengah mencari seorang wanita Melayu, Lisa, yang suci, pakai tudung, memang tak kuning. So, I very hard akan pegang watak utama dalam cerita-cerita Akasia, mega drama. Very hard for me to hold that role, but I don't blame. It's not my fault. It's not their fault or anything. It's just the story lah. It's quite hard to be given the opportunity. I went to 3 reality shows and then I got nowhere. You know, nowadays, our industry is very different from 5-6 years ago. Masa tu Instagram tak booming. You nak popular, you nak watak, you nak berlakon. Masa tu YouTube pun tak booming eh. You nak berlakon, you know, you have to really suck up to the big ones. You have to go to big production house, big director. Those were the very big names. You could TV3, whatever, Astro. And I didn't know how to break into that. Okay, aku pergi Google. Okay, ini alamat. I drive pergi sana parking. Hi, nak hantar profile saya? Okay, dia letak ambil profile you. Oh, letak dalam ni. Tak ada orang kan tengok. So back then, there were no avenues for me to... How do I know about any auditions? Well, I go on Facebook, I join casting, but that's it. There's no news there of anything. But that time, there were a lot of reality shows. Masa tu kan TV booming. And reality show tu diheba-hebakan. So I went as a peserta, you know, I joined 3. Menang the last one. But still, I got nowhere. And then I masuk Aswara. Okay, konon-konon okay, kita belajar berlakon, kenal orang, dapat buat untuk film festival, dapat menempel nama lah. Still tak dapat. Then, football hosting came. Actually, to be honest, I'm not a big fan of football. But I watched football growing up with my dad. Tapi I'm not a fan of football and it was never my career path. But my mistake was, I stayed in it too long. I stayed in it for 4 years. Until I met someone, which was my ex-boyfriend, who actually told me that, like, you should get out of it and start doing what you want to do because this is not contributing to your long-term goal. And I said, that is true. You know, even when I was a football host, I still knocked on doors, but people tend to associate me as a football host. I think still till today. But you know, I try and try. And then my big break came bila masa tu I was considered very lucky. Sebab masa tu Michael Ang, masa tu Mawar Rashid pulled out of the Hero Seorang Cinderella. So they were looking for a girl. And then at that time, a talent. At that time, I was speaking to a few management to be my manager. And one of them rapat dengan Michael Ang. So introduce my name. Michael Ang tu macam tak yakin dengan Ayla sebab dia pun Cina, I Cina. Betul ke perempuan ni Minah ni boleh cakap Cina kan? Dia ambil I masuk, desperate. So I was lucky, I got it. Still after I did that, I did get a bit of break, but you know, nothing very solid because of my pelat, you know, which I'm trying so hard. I tiap-tiap hari doh, I dengar Hot FM lah, I tengok drama pukul 7 lah. You know, I siap tau, I pergi Kelantan tau, I pergi beli 5 novel. Every day I akan baca, lepas tu kawan I kata, eh tak boleh lah baca tu, patutlah bahasa baku. I was like, okay ni macam mana ni. But actually, I'm very fascinated with the Al-Quran because it is the final book, you know. After Bible, it is the Quran. Just cuma, it's such a shame, I tak tahu reti nak baca lah. But I feel that it's nice to read because it's our last and final book. I am curious. But I never got the chance. Tapi mungkin I patut kot. Alah, susahlah. Dah dalam diri kita dah Cina tu. Macam mana nak buat ni? Even till today, it's very hard for me to get the roles that I want. It's very, very hard. Sebab dalam minda orang, I masih orang Cina. I cannot change my look. Kita bukan di Korea.